ब्राजील एट लीस्ट 94 पीपल हैव किल्ड फ्रॉम फ्लड एंड मड स्लाइड्स दैट स्वेप्ट अवे होम्स एंड कार्स इन द सिटी ऑफ पेट्रोपोलिस रियो डी जेनेरियो स्टेट्स गवर्नमेंट हैज कंफर्मड बट इवन एज फैमिलीज प्रिपेयर टू बरी देयर डेड इट वॉज अंडर थर्सडे हाउ मेनी बॉडीज रिमेन ट्रैप्ड इन द मड रूबेन्स बॉम्ब टेम्पो मेयर ऑफ द जर्मन इन्फ्लुएंस सिटी नेसल्ड इन द माउंटेन्स डिडंट इवन ऑफर एन एस्टिमेट फॉर द नंबर ऑफ पीपल मिसिंग विथ रिकवरी एफर्ट स्टिल ऑन गोइंग वी डोंट येट नो द फुल स्केल ऑफ दिस Bomb Tempo said at a news conference Wednesday. It was a hardy day, a difficult day. More than 24 hours after the deadly deluge, early Tuesday, survivors were digging to find lost loved ones, Rio de Janeiro's public prosecutor's office said in a statement Wednesday night that it had compiled a list of 35 people yet to be located. Footage posted on social media showed torrents dragging cars and houses through the streets and water swirling through the city. One video showed two buses sinking into a swollen river as its passengers clambered out the windows, scrambling for safety. Some didn't make it to the banks and were washed away out of sight. On Wednesday morning, houses were left buried beneath mud while appliances and cars were piles on the streets. Petropolis, named for a former Brazilian empire, has been a refuge for people escaping the summer heat and tourists keen to explore the so-called Imperial City. Its prosperity has also drawn poorer residents from Rio's poorer regions. Its population grew haphazardly, climbing mountain sides now covered with small residences packed tightly together. Many are in areas unfit for structures and made more vulnerable by deforestation and inadequate drainage. The state fire department said 25.8 centimeters, just over 10 inches of rain fell within 3 hours on Tuesday.